Before we proceed on our discussion, let me present to you our objectives. At the end of this video, you should be able to define and illustrate distance formula. Find the distance between a pair of points in a coordinate plane. Apply the distance formula in solving problems. Let's get started. Let's have a quick review. Give the coordinates of the vertices of rectangle LOVE. To find the coordinates of the vertices of rectangle LOVE, we need to remember that the set of ordered pair is in the form of x, y, wherein x is the x coordinate or the abscissa, and y is the y coordinate or the ordinate. Let's start with the first point. What are the coordinates of point L? Correct! We have negative 2, comma 6, because we have negative 2 for the x coordinate and 6 for the y coordinate. How about the coordinates of point O? That is right! We have 8, comma 6, because the abscissa is 8 and 6 is the ordinate. How about the coordinates of point V? That's correct. We have 8, comma, negative 2 because the x coordinate is 8 and the y coordinate is negative 2. And lastly, the point E. That is right. The coordinates of point E are negative 2, negative 2, since both the x coordinate and the y coordinate are negative 2. Since we already know how to get the coordinates of each point in a Cartesian plane, what if you want to find the distance between each point? Like for example, you want to find the length of segment LO, segment OV, segment VE, segment LE, or even the length of each diagonals, such as the length of segment LV and the length of segment OE. That is what we're going to discover in this video. We can think the distance as the length between a starting point and an ending point, just like the starting line and the ending line in a car race. Let's say that the distance from a starting point to the finishing point is 1000 meters. For this lesson, we are concerned in finding the distance between two endpoints connected by a line segment. In this case, the line segment is AM. We must remember that the distance between two points are non-negative. It is positive when the points are different, and it is zero when the points are the same. If we measure using a ruler, we can say that the segment AM or MA measures 9 cm. We are going to extend this idea by finding the distance of two points in a coordinate plane. When finding the distance on a coordinate plane, our tool is not going to be a ruler, but the distance formula. The distance formula is an equation that can be used to find the distance between any points in a coordinate plane. Given the coordinates of point 1 is x sub 1 and y sub 1, and the point 2 as x sub 2, y sub 2, then the distance formula is defined as d is equal to the square root of x sub 2 minus x sub 1 quantity squared plus quantity y sub 2 minus y sub 1 quantity squared. Let's have an example. We're going to find the length of the segment AM. Since we're looking for the length, we're going to use the distance formula. To use the distance formula, first, we need to get the coordinates of the endpoints A and M. The coordinates of point A are negative 3, comma 4, since negative 3 is the x coordinate and 4 is the y coordinate. The coordinates of point M are 5, comma 1, since 5 is the abscissa and 1 is the ordinate. Let's say that point A is the first point and point M is the second point. Again, A and M are both points with x and y coordinates. Since A is the first point, we will give the 1, so we have x sub 1, y sub 1. And since M is the second point, we will give the 2, so we have x sub 2, y sub 2. Now, we're ready to use the formula. Let's start by looking the x sub 1 and x sub 2. X sub 1 is negative 3 and x sub 2 is 5. So we have 5 minus negative 3, replacing x sub 2 minus x sub 1 in the first parentheses. Also, our y sub 1 is 4 and y sub 2 is 1. So we have 1 minus 4, replacing y sub 2 minus y sub 1 in the second parentheses. So the resulting equation is segment AM is equal to the square root of quantity 5 minus negative 3 quantity squared plus quantity 1 minus 4 quantity squared. After substitution, we can now solve. 5 minus negative 3 is equal to 8 and 1 minus 4 is equal to negative 3. So we have segment AM is equal to the square root of 8 squared plus negative 3 squared. 8 squared is equal to 64, since 8 times 8 is equal to 64. Negative 3 squared is equal to 9, since negative 3 times negative 3 is equal to positive 9. 64 plus 9 is equal to 73. So segment AM is equal to the square root of 73, or write it in decimal form, which is 8.54. Let's have another example. Find the lengths of the sides of triangle ABC. Then identify what kind of triangle is triangle ABC. First, we need to identify the coordinates of ABC. The coordinates of point A are negative 2, comma 1, since negative 2 is the x coordinate and 1 is the y coordinate. The coordinates of B is 3, comma 4, since 3 is the abscissa and 4 is the ordinate. The coordinates of point C is 3, comma negative 2, since 3 is the abscissa and negative 2 is the ordinate. After we determine the coordinates, we can now solve the length of the sides using the distance formula. Segment AB, segment BC, and segment AC. Then, we will choose what kind of triangle is triangle ABC. The choices are Isosceles triangle if no sides are equal, Isosceles triangle if two sides are equal, an equilateral triangle if all of the sides are equal. Let's start with segment AB. Given the points A and B, let's say that A is the first point. So we have x sub 1 is equal to negative 2 and y sub 1 is equal to 1. The second point is the point B. So we have x sub 2 is equal to 3 and y sub 2 is equal to 4. Applying the distance formula, we can now substitute the given values. Since we're looking for segment AB, we have segment AB is equal to the square root of 3 minus negative 2 quantity squared plus 4 minus 1 quantity squared. Simplify inside the parentheses. So we have segment AB is equal to the square root of 5 squared plus 3 squared. Since 3 minus negative 2 is equal to 5 and 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Then 5 squared plus 3 squared is equal to 25 plus 9. So we have segment AB is equal to the square root of 25 plus 9. 25 plus 9 is equal to 34. So segment AB is equal to the square root of 34. Since 34 is not a perfect square, this is the final answer. Segment AB is equal to the square root of 34. After we solve the distance of segment AB, which is equal to the square root of 34, let us now solve the distance of segment BC. The length of segment BC. Given the points B and C, let's say that the first point is the point B. So we have x sub 1 is equal to 3 and y sub 1 is equal to 4. The second point is the point C. So we have x sub 2 is equal to 3 and y sub 2 is equal to negative 2. Applying the distance formula, let's substitute the given values. So we have segment BC is equal to the square root of quantity 3 minus 3 quantity squared plus quantity negative 2 minus 4 quantity squared. After we substitute the given values, we can now simplify inside the parentheses. 3 minus 3 is equal to 0, negative 2 minus 4 is equal to negative 6. So we have segment BC is equal to the square root of 0 squared plus negative 6 squared. 0 squared is equal to 0, negative 6 squared is equal to 36. So we have the square root of 36. Since 36 is a perfect square, the square root of 36 is equal to 6. Therefore, the distance of B to C is 6. After we solve the distance of segment AB, which is equal to the square root of 34, and segment BC is equal to 6, let us now solve the distance of segment AC. The length of segment AC. Given the points A and C, let's say that the first point is point A. So we have x sub 1 is equal to negative 2 and y sub 1 is equal to 1. The second point is point C. So we have x sub 2 is equal to 3 and y sub 2 is equal to negative 2. Applying the distance formula, let's substitute the given values. So we have segment AC is equal to the square root of quantity 3 minus negative 2 quantity squared plus quantity negative 2 minus 1 quantity squared. Simplify inside the parentheses. 3 minus negative 2 is equal to 5. Negative 2 minus 1 is equal to negative 3. So we have segment AC is equal to the square root of 5 squared plus negative 3 squared. 5 squared is equal to 25 and negative 3 squared is equal to 9. So we have square root of 25 plus 9. 25 plus 9 is equal to 34. So we have segment AC is equal to the square root of 34. Since we're done solving for the length of the triangle ABC, what kind of triangle do we have? Correct! Isosceles triangle. Since only two sides of the triangle are equal, the side AB and the side AC.